absolutely stupid first. Yes, I do. I want to play some vampires. And not the Rakdos kind. I think everybody wants to be the Rakdos kind, but I want to play some Aura black-white vampires. Along with their big buddies Gideon and Avacyn. What an unlikely group of allies. There you are. Missed you. There's our little buddy. I want to try to use this card. And that card. And those guys, because they are vampires. Don't know if you knew it. We're not doing any madness tricks. We're not trying to force ourselves to discard anything. Just trying to gain a bunch of life and beat down. We will run some Liliana, because, you know, she's not a vampire, but she could be team vampire. She's team zombie, really, if you read the stories. She's very team zombie. Kalitas. Kalitas. This guy. Go big or go home. But he never really threw down with vampires. He's a demon guy, but we can, he'll lend a hand for one night only. Anguish Unmaking, because we're going to gain all that life, so we don't really care if we have to lose some of it killing stuff. And there we go. One thing I've been learning about this format very early on is it often seems that the first person who misses a land drop is doomed. So we're going to run a lot of land. I'm gonna run 26. I missed a lot of land drops today. I lost 7 games where I marked that it was because I never drew that third land on time. So I'm gonna try to not fall into that this evening. I should probably have a Rogue's Passage in a deck like this. Now that we have lands too, like Shambling Vents and No Acid Moss, Westvale Abbey, we actually get to use our big lands. That's a big deal. I wonder if it's any good to have things like Foundry of the Consoles. I mean, that doesn't really synergize with a single thing going on in the deck. There is kind of a life gain element that makes me wonder if I want to run a Blighted Step, but I don't know about that. Eh. How many brown lands is that? That's 4. But how much white mana do we really need? Not that much. Nah, we'll keep it like this. One in the morning. How late will we go tonight? I do have to be at a dinner tomorrow night and act at 5:30, act like a human. So, at some point I should sleep. A nice place too. Making me think I have to not embarrass my wife. So what am I gonna do? Am I gonna edit some decks or are we gonna dance? Let's dance. I was told there's some vanilla cards I only get by doing the campaign, but I'm really not that interested. Trying to chill out here at the end of the day. Hey, we got a game. Hallelujah. I do have a lot of decks built, though. I worked on a whole bunch of things while I was off off the Twitch. As much as I love Twitch, and I plan to keep loving Twitch, and I love playing on Twitch, I don't do my best building, I find, on Twitch. I do my best building when I really take my time. I'm watching a TV show, sitting on the couch upstairs with my wife. That's when I seem to really get the decks a lot better. I don't know why. When I'm using my iPad, I can build pretty well. When I'm using my Xbox, for some reason, I seem to come up short most of the time. Red mana. Oh boy. Let's see what he's got for us. As we walk right into a Twin Bolt. Yeah, or a Fiery Impulse. Our opponent could not wait to kill our critter. Fiery Impulse meta, man. I've seen so many Fiery Impulses today. I've seen multiple games where my opponent drew 3 or 4 Fiery Impulses in their top 12 cards. Uh-oh. Prowess, maybe? Are we gonna flood out? Good. Let's see if he's got another one. But, you know, Child of Night is a piece of crap. It gets outclassed in combat really fast. Pair of 5 drops. Not where you want to be going into turn 3. And our opponent's passing the turn, so... I mean, we're not getting any younger. Get in there, Child of the Night. Go get fried. Here it comes. No. Okay, sweep away. Not what I expected. Could be worse. What are the strong colors in the new set? Hello, USA F-Man 12. The strong colors. Well, it's kind of to be determined. And that's a bit of a cop-out answer, but I think we're all still working on figuring out what the best colors are. I mean, it's really tempting to say green and red. They've been strong. They've been strong for quite a while. But white got Declaration, Stone, and Avacyn. Those are some really good cards, but they're not common, so... It's not like you're gonna draw them every game. I like the werewolves a lot. I mean, that's been something I've been really touting. Our opponent's got Jesse and Thief action. Let's send in... See if he's got anything for us. Doesn't look like it. You know, the colorless cards. the strong colors in the set. How about the no colors? I think that's a safe bet. Uh-oh, Clutch Occurrence. You got me. You got me. Alrighty. Say hello to my little angel friend. Have I played an Aristocrat deck like yet? I don't think anything I'd define like Aristocrats. That deck, man, that deck misses Perilous Mirror, but... nothing I'd quite describe as Aristocrats. Not like the last set of Aristocrats that we had. That was kind of a... That deck was a thing all its own, you know what I mean? Let's get in there. Hit for 4. Is Clue a good mechanic? Clue is okay. I don't love Clues. Like, it just... Clues... are not drawing a card, you still have to pay 2 mana to draw the card. And that you know, that's obvious, but it's very real. You have to pay another 2 mana if you're gonna draw the card. That's a problem. So, is Clue a good mechanic? It's a mechanic. It's better to get a Clue than nothing, but I haven't quite found where I want Clues. Oh, jeez, he's done? He's I mean, he was totally rocking. He was kicking my butt, and then I had one turn where I ambushed him with Avacyn and followed it with Amyxilis, and he's out. Okay. Well, I don't want. Let's do some AI takeover. What have you got, AI? He's got Disperse. Okay. And Jace. I mean, I guess he conceded because he didn't think he'd have a shot at winning. There's that guy that flips, but I just mean a deck that abuses sacrifice tokens slash no token cards. You mean the Pious Evangel guy? I was playing around with him. I was also playing with that, whatever that green enchantment is that makes a clue whenever something dies and makes a human every time you sacrifice a clue. You know what I'm talking about? So I was messing with those cards. I haven't really found a mix that works. Would you like to brew up some aristocrats? I can't really think of what I would put in the decks at this point. We could kill Jace. I'm not really scared of Jace. I mean, what can he do? He can disperse, sweep away. I mean, he can't do too much, really. I think I'll just keep drawing cards and keep the loyalty going up. But yeah, that enchantment didn't really impress me. It was very slow. It did not do too much. Man, what kind of an aristocrat deck can you even? I mean, you can try to make the deck from the last set, like Blister Pod, Carrier Thrall, and all that, but that didn't really pick up much, which is a problem. You don't want to play decks that didn't gain anything from the last set. I don't really like, I think a lot of people like that tracker creature that gets you landfall clues, but I don't really like it. Like, I don't think a 3/2 that just sits there is really where you want to be. Seems too easy to kill. Seems like an awkward trade. Not that happy with that guy. Willbreaker. Well, he could have just gained control of Avacyn, but the AI decided to play this game backwards. So, there's that. I think I want to flip Avacyn. I think that's pretty clear. So we can do. I know how to do that. Sacrifice a creature to put a +1/+1 counter on vampires you can draw. So I think we'll get you out there. A target for woodland. A target for bellower? There are much better targets for bellower now, in my opinion. There are much better targets for bellower. Do, 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 do. So let's flip Avacyn over. Get beefy. Here it comes. Kaboom. And let's do three to his face. And there, we got some zombies. And we got a Scion. I don't think sometimes you want clues. I think you want cards. And I think you want power. That's my opinion. I mean, yeah. No, I don't think some. I think the last couple formats with duels, and this is just my opinion, but in the last few formats of duels, there wasn't a lot of way to gain card advantage, right? So things like clues would have been awesome in the last few formats, but now, We actually have a lot of ways to gain card advantage, and we just have powerful cards to play at great costs, right? So I don't think it's as important to find clever ways to draw cards, and that's kind of what clues are to me, a clever way to draw cards. They're fun, you can play them, but if you have the option between playing a Tamiyo's Journal that makes clues, or an Archangel Avacyn or an Obnixilis, those all cost 5 mana, right? I mean, you know which ones are powerful. The thing is, we've got such a bigger pool of cards now that you can just play more powerful cards. You don't need to draw more and more cards. You can just play more power. That's the way I'm looking at it, or trying to. And, to be fair, I haven't won that many, like, I haven't done that great since the expansion dropped. Not as well as I hoped to. So, you can laugh at me and say I don't have this figured out, and I would say you're right. I have not figured the format out quite yet, but I certainly feel like the person who plays Sylvan Advocate on turn two is way ahead of the person who plays Elvish Visionary on turn two. And if you're the person playing Tireless Tracker on turn three, I would much rather be the person playing a three drop of larger size or more raw power usefulness. So what did we just play against? It was like blue-red control. Oh, it's worth testing. Everything's worth testing. That's why we have new cards. You should play all the new cards if you have the time, and you should especially play the ones that tickle your fancy. No matter what I say about them. Vampires. Freaking vampires. So, I'll play one more here, and then I want to try some of the decks I've been, well, this is one of the decks I built on iOS, but this is probably the worst one. It's just a silly vampire theme deck, you know? Nothing too crazy. I wish I could do better than Child of Night, but I don't know if I can. Child of Night is a lifelink. The deck has a life gain theme. Ugh, I hate 2/1s. I hate 2/1s so much. At least Carrier Thrall, if it dies, you get another Scion, but Child of Night just seems like a glutton for punishment. But yeah, next I probably play my silly Boros deck. My silly Boros weapons deck. Nope. Oop. Yeah, okay. What could go wrong? We got our lady again. Card's just ridiculous. Pretty much ruins games for opponents all by itself. Here's another new card and a reason I built the deck. Whenever you gain life, each opponent loses one life. So that's not the same as like if I gain 5 life, my opponent loses 5 life. It's anytime I gain life. So if I gain 5 life, my opponent loses 1 life. If I gain 1 life 5 times, my opponent loses 1 life 5 times. Make sense? All right. See what our opponent wants to do. Looks like Thopters. Let's see if it's Thoptery. Yep, it's Thoptery. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. Well, I know a card that loves Thopters. There she is. I know I'm not making trades, but I want my Scion. I've got plans. Yep, Whirl a Rogue, go figure. So, I want to wipe his board, so that means I'm actually not going to block here with the Scion. I'm going to play Archangel next turn and then flip her, so that she just wraths away all this mess. Yep, and we'll play her now while he's tapped out. Sacrifice the Scion. Archangel Avacyn will flip on his upkeep. And his board's going bye-bye. Best sweeper in the house. Bam. Card is so good. So now what you got? He's got another chief. So he might be able to reload. Let's find out. Passing turn. There's something he wants to play. What do you suppose it could be? So this turn is probably a Emissary Visitor turn. But let's get in there. We're actually not even close to using the Visitor. If I put it out there, it probably just dies, but it's the most mana-efficient play, and it's not going to get any better. Unless I wait for both of us to be empty-handed, that could be a while. Let's see what he's got to rebuild. Artificer's Epiphany. Draw some cards, Mr. Thopter Man. What else you got? Hey, he's giving it a good think. Maybe a Thopter Engineer? Maybe an Esperzoa? Nope, Pilgrim's Eye. Well, that's probably not going to be as good as he needs. Drain him for one. We declaration that in stone. We hit him for eight. And he has to block with his chief. That's not bad, but it's not that good. And I feel like I might be able to do better. Let's just send in the clowns. Send in the knuckleheads. Archangel Avacyn still beats a Chandra in her current condition, so I'm just going to dump my hand. I guess he could Fiery Impulse and Chandra, but let's make him do it if that's what he's going to do. There's the Twin Bolt. Okay. No problem, you got him. Aligned Hedron Network. There's a trick. But that's not going to save him. And okay. Our opponent concedes. All we had to do next was attack and win. So there it is. So, hard to say that Black-White Vampires is a good deck. It's more like Archangel Avacyn is a good card. This is what we're learning right here. Card is nuts. Okay, let's see. We want anthems. We want anthems. Alright, so the deck we're gonna show off is my weapons deck. Ki. Yes, I built this. Not saying it's great, but it's not horrible yet. Trying to figure out the right way to say that. I mean, it is hyper aggressive. It is super aggressive. Which means sometimes it just wins games that, you know, it really shouldn't. If the opponent's deck is slow, tapped lands, things like that, the deck can just go off the wall. And yes, we're gonna play with a Bonesaw. So, get ready for Bonesaw. Ooh, yeah. Dig it, dig it. It's got kind of a human sub-theme going on. It plays a lot of humans. Got Thalia, can put counters on humans. Got that Firecraft action. Got the Thopter Engineer, which is a human, makes a Thopter, which is usually the important part, but the Engineer himself, he's human. So is Pia and Kieran, they human. What deck are you asking is too linear? Vampires? I actually think that the only way Vampires wins is because it was by having, like, awesome Planeswalkers and Archangel Avacyn and things like that. So there's probably a better home for cards like Archangel Avacyn. It's probably not the best deck to abuse those cards. It just won a few games because it happens to have them. Wait, isn't Keep bugged? Yeah, it is. There are ways to get it to work. And hopefully I'll get to show you some of those ways. Flipping over an equipment would be one of them. Flipping over equipment does the trick. It's an interesting problem that we have. So that's 37 cards. What am I missing? There's some two of that I didn't add, I guess. Got the Always Watching, yep. Got the Firecraft. Got the Declaration Stone. Oh, yeah, Relic Seeker. Didn't add those Relic Seekers to go get that equipment. We're running a really risky land count. I'm not sure that it's right. In fact, it's very likely it's not right. Because it's really cutting it close. One way that this deck just loses is by having lands come into play tap too much. And we've already got two Needle Spires, so we're just running the one of Stone Quandary. And this is our weapons deck. It's a noisy little thing. Max is out at 4 mana, so we're going to try 21 land. And we'll see if that, you know, works out. But we are running Bonesaw. We're running Bonesaw with Abbott. That's a prowess combo. And we can also fetch it with this guy and this guy. And just having Bonesaws out means Weapons Trainer goes off and makes our guys bigger. And then we use Menace to get through and punch the opponent in the face. We can also load up our equipment on a Thopter token from Thopter Engineer or Piacurin. So, ready to see this thing go out there and get massacred? I played a few games with it on iOS, and it hasn't lost. It's done fine. Hasn't had a lot of competition either. So, not trying to overblow its abilities. Searching for the players. Where are the players? Not sure how long I'll make it tonight, but I know I'm not completely ready to go to sleep yet. Too many cards. Too much stuff to do. Bugs often mean you can still play the card, you just gotta be creative. Alright, we're up against a dragon. Nope, can't do that. Can definitely do this hand, though. Okay. They should have made more cards that work like the vampire cards that gain one life when it gets tapped. Eh, they need better cards that do that. That vampire ain't so good. He's fine, but I'm not gonna give him a stamp of approval. Sorry about that. Just checking my hand. Let's do this. What deck is this, Boros Allies? Well, no, not really. It's got a slight ally theme because we do want Menace and we do want this guy to work, but it's mostly a human deck, human equipment deck. So you'd like more creatures that when they attack you gain life. Yeah, that, I mean, there's Lifelink in the set. Okay, he's gonna straight up Twin Bolt my Relic Seeker. Aren't you no fun? Firecraft off the top, so that comes in. I'll go with red, play a Fire Mantle. We'll cohort it. And hey, we hit something. How about that? Skeleton Key, which will give a creature of our choice Sulk, and when it deals damage, we can draw a card, discard a card. There's an engineer, so it looks like finally our opponent has revealed their Thopter intentions. There's a human. I'll put that out there. And we'll dig for a bone saw because we can. Yes! There we go. Zero mana, bone saw. Oh, I see. You're looking for ways to make Cohort not such a piece of trash ability. I feel ya. I hear what you're saying now. I get what you're throwing down. I'm with you there. Yep, here comes a 4-spot. But don't you worry. Ain't nothing I can't handle. Get in there. Pretty good hit. I love it. I've done my thing. I've attacked with all my creatures, and now it's up to my opponent to abuse me as I'm completely tapped out. Okay, and he's holding up. Let's do it like this. Thinking. What could be in his hand? A brutal expulsion? Yeah, probably a twin bolt. A fiery impulse, sure. I had a feeling, but we got a good crack in. Yep, crack your clue. See what you draw for that Zoa. And he's got the twin bolt, he's got, oops. Okay, so that can give menace. So let's save that for if he draws a way to make a bunch of blockers. Let's put this over here. There's no reason to really equip this, but we'll put it over here just in case. He's at 6. So this will get him to Uno. So we'll get in with those. It feels like we're just kind of, let's see, do I want to use the skeleton key? Yeah. Yep, we can discard that card. And we'll save Abbott for next turn. More lands from our Thopter Man, and he better have an answer right here, right now. Exquisite Firecraft, okay. Takes out my Engineer. Chief of the Foundry, yep. So I guess if I had kept the ally, we would have won with the with the menace ability, but let's see if we can flip one like a boss. Let's also see if this goes off without a bug. Well, that's not an ally. But as you can see, you can make Abbott go off, and you have an equipment sitting around to use. Hello, use my equipment. I'm trying to use you. Game is sinking. Game sinking. So we'll put it over here, and now he can't block the Corb. He has to block the Fire Mantle Mage, which means he loses his chief. Haven't seen any Madness deck yet. So you want me to play a Madness deck? Is that what you're asking? I've got a Madness deck. Okay, that goes away. Land for my foe means this one's over. Unzor is ready. I will find my way. I can go the distance. I don't care how far. I know I'll be strong. I know every mile will be worth my while. Cash. Cash money. So that's my ally deck, but let's go back in and let's update my vampire deck so you can see some madness happening. I have changed it since I ran it last quite a bit. I found that doing a lot of the madness shenanigans with the really cheap cards, the cheap red and black, like hyper aggro cards, wasn't very good because they just get like killed by Languish and stuff, and it's a really bad experience. So instead, what I'm doing is just, I kind of made a deck just loaded with haste. I mean, just absolutely loaded up on the haste cards. This is one of them. And we still keep the Bloodseeker for the Madness outlet. But we get rid of a lot of what I would call gimmick material. And just keep threats that get in there. So every time our opponent wipes the board, we're just back on the board attacking again. And again and again. So that's kind of the evil agenda we're going to run here. And haste is a much more red mechanic than black. So let's get over to red. There's some haste. There's some more haste. Some burn. Like some really solid burn. We just want, you know, if our opponent's gonna wipe our board, we're gonna come right back. Thopter Engineer is, you know, haste, but we're looking for some things that hit harder. And what this is gonna do is drive ramp decks and control decks a batty, because every time they think they've got us out of the way, anytime they have sorcery speed removal, we're gonna punish them. And that's, anyway, that's what I'm running right now. The 3-5-1 for 3 Madness is, not what I'm... Yeah, I'm taking out Kalidus. Doesn't have haste. Like, I'm really all in on this. This is more of a haste deck than a Madness deck, but it has enough Madness in it to use the some of the cards. But I think you'll see, it's pretty tough to deal with. It's not as synergy driven, but it is, it's a house. What am I missing? Reality Smasher. There we go. And then in the mana base column, 5 and 5. Those and those, Drown Yard thingy majiggy. There we go. Rogue's Passage, yep. That won me a game on iOS today. Huge Rogue's Passage draw. And 3 of those, yep. So, Gemini, go to sleep. Why? Well, just because something's a 3-5 that dodges Languish doesn't make it good. I mean, I may as well play Rotted Hulk. So, let's take this out. Supposedly now, this is the last deck I edited, so supposedly it'll go right to this when I go to a game. There we go. Nice. We're just going to burn and we're going to charge. That's the big plan. After that, I have a pretty fun Abzan list. I can't wait to try more. And then a green-black Delirium list that has been surprising me by how fun it is. So, well, I don't know if we'll get to all of it tonight, but we'll certainly see what happens. How can one sleep when there's so many games to be played, so many cards to be tested? I don't understand. Obviously, if Gemini could sleep, Gemini would sleep, instead of being here scolding me with periods and capitalized words. I think we have to do better. Yeah, okay. Tap land start. Boo! But that's okay. It's not a hyper fast deck. It's not. Because that other vampires, like the Super Madness Vampires deck, when it tries to be hyper fast, it does not go very well. I've gotta tell ya. Because the creatures on their own are pretty. You know, they're just kind of so-so. They're not impressive by any means. Let's get in there. Rawr. If he plays Engineer, you better believe I will Firecraft that thing. Oh, he's gonna Firecraft my Forerunner. Okay. Well, that leaves me without much to do this turn, and that's never good. So let's hope we draw something in the range that we can cast, which is most of the deck. But a land is not it. A land is not it. But we'll need that land when we get to Chandra to wreck his face. Alrighty. Well, he's gonna start making little thopter babies over there with his vial. And there's a Duskstalker, but let's be mana efficient and throw out the youths, since they'll stick to the battlefield. Bam. He gets his first little taste of Thopterness. And his Whirler Rogue is going to be very sad when he sees what I do to them. So like the last two games where we learned not so much about our deck, but that Archangel Avacyn is a good card, we're going to learn that Chandra is a good card right now. Bye-bye, Thopters. All of the haste, all of the haste, all of the haste. So if we draw a land, we can do both of these. If we don't, we can do this and that. Or no, we can't. We don't have enough red. So we can do this and this. Yeah, we can do that. Good call. And there goes your last artifact. So let's see if he has a Chandra to match up with our Chandra. I dislike that I can never get the right build for my ramp deck. You know, Gemini, you told me today that you perfected ramp. What happened? Ah, there's Lava Axe, but, you know, all we gotta do is this. Roasty toasty. So let's see. 4D. I heard that you have to delete your decks and rebuild them, like any decks from before the expansion. So that was. Anybody remember what we went up against with our Boros weapons? Anybody remember what deck we played against? It was just a few minutes ago. What did he have? He had Fiery Impulse, he had Twin Bolt. I think it was Thopters. If so, that's three straight Thopter decks tonight. Three straight wins? So, against Thopter decks. We'll do one more and I'll bust out Abzan. Abzan Gitrog Ever After. Abzan Gitrog Ever After. Fun name. How goes it tonight? I'm pretty mellow tonight. I played until 5 in the morning and I slept until about 10, got up. I watched some Magic. I watched the new video from Legend. I read some stuff on the forums, people going nuts about glitches. And I think before noon, I was back in here streaming again. And I streamed until 9 p.m. And then I watched some TV with my wife till about 1 a.m. And now I'm back. So that's my day. Pretty good day. Good life, you know. Just, I took this, I let everybody know I was not to be disturbed from Wednesday night onward. So I've got like this whole week and weekend to just play this game that I like so much. So I can't complain. I get to hang out with all you guys and play Magic. I do have a dinner tomorrow night, and it's like formal with people that we want to impress. So I have to go get a haircut and look nice for that. But and I have to get some sleep tonight so I don't look like a lunatic. But I don't have to sleep now. I can sleep a little later. Hey, everybody notice it does switch to the last deck that we edited. We don't have to hop around anymore. Legend has some good tech. What was his good tech? Or is that just a word that we mean to say that he's doing well? I didn't see any particular technology that I didn't expect. It's like everybody's Planeswalker deck will be a little different based on how much they value certain cards. Right? So, I'm not surprised by a single card in Legend's deck. I was like, yep, that's about what I'd expect. Playing Azkaban. Playing Azkaban Ever After. I was playing it yesterday without Ever After. Today I opened it, and it's like I always have infinite creatures. Yeah, man. That card is good. This hand is good. I can agree with you on that. Ever After is, it's really something in that deck. So how about that curve? We can go 2 drop, and if we draw lands, which is why we run 26 of them, so we can curve out, we can go this for 2 drop, this for a hasty 3, this for a hasty 4, this for a hasty 5, if we draw 2 lands in here somewhere. The Bloodseeker stays in because we do want to enable madness on some of our cards, like Fiery Temper, and the hasty guy, the 4-3. So we want to definitely have a little madness action in here. The Incorrigible use, there they are. So I guess that's the play, right? Let's see if our opponent has Gideon's Reproach, Reprisal, or any of that noise. Or if we just get to crack him for 7 on turn 3. 7 it is. Bam. Haste, baby. Do it with, if you're gonna do it with haste. So our opponent's probably questioning what the heck to do about this situation. Can't help ya. I am the enemy. But he's got Boros and more Boros. Boros. And he's passing the turn. Not sure what to think of that. So I think we just want to do this. More haste. Eldrazi Obligator is another house, man. That card is great. I don't know if we'll need it here, though. So I'm not going to discard anything. I just, I don't know. Don't want to get twin bolted. And now he's pausing me as he's down to 6. I got 3 creatures and 3 lands, and he's just got 3 lands, and he's passing the turn. What the heck could his hand be? You don't know how it doesn't get played? It does get played. Oh, you're probably just saying, I don't know how someone wouldn't play that. I agree. It's the card is nuts. So he's at 6. He can stop that. He takes 1, 2. If I play this, he just dies. Same thing with Fiery Temper, but... yeah. Everything has haste, dude. It's all so much haste. So every time he thinks he's every time he thinks he's figured something like this out, he just gets clobbered. If he sweeps the board, he still gets punched the next turn. So what do you suppose that deck even was? Oros. Control. I mean, it was definitely a losing deck, is what that was. I think we'll just even... we're just gonna cross that off the board. I don't even know what he was playing. We killed him so fast. Let's get into our Abzan list and make some updates to what I've been messing with lately. So far, every time I've played this deck on iOS, I've just, like, steamrolled. Just steamrolled the enemy. It's been brutal. Just cut those Sylvan Rangers because we have such better cards to play early in the game. Such better cards. Those Sylvan Rangers, man, think of the past. In my opinion. If you're going to play four colors, and probably some three colors, it's fine, but I don't think I need it. Where's my F-bags? Now, these cards, they're not quite what they used to be, but I think they still fit in here. Also, we don't even have Evolutionary Leap in this deck, which is strange. I don't have this Nissa in here. That's, I don't know if that's necessarily great. It's the way it is. I have 2 Anguish Unmakings. I think we can keep that Nissa. Alright, let's see if we can make room for it. 2 of those. Kalitas, where are you? You made the cut. I remember you making many zombies and making me happy. No Evil Leap, yeah. I don't think I want to be spending my time using Evil Leap. I want to spend my time be playing awesome creatures. That's why no Evil Leap. Pretty bizarre. I agree. It's strange. I was very much a fan of the Evil Leap Origins deck. But the closer we get to, you know, just being able to play massive threats, and I just think that that's the better way to go. Yitrog's in there. That's in there. 2 Languish. Kalidas. Anguish Unmaking. Oh, we're on 1 Anguish Unmaking instead of 2. So we can run a Nissa? Is that the difference? I think what I'll do instead is pull 1 Oath of Gideon. I don't think it's a 2 of card. If I have it, it's great. You know, there are times where you curve on it and everything's beautiful, but it's really not like a power card. Compared to having another Nissa in the deck, yeah, you get what I'm saying. In fact, I think I'm actually gonna try pulling that other Oath altogether and put in my Hydra, because I do love my Hydra lately. Now, that gives us a lot of 6 drops, which that may be too many. We'll have to find out. Let's up the land count quite a bit. and no evolving wilds. Yeah, that was the other change. As few tap lands as I can get away with. So yeah, this is a pretty raw power deck. We are running 26 lands. Gotta hit those land drops if we're gonna play those big guys. Let's change that add Xan. Miss that typo. Yeah. Let's spin those wheels. It'll be fun. Abzan, it's kind of a super friends, but I mean, there's really only three planeswalkers. Oh, four, I guess. Or five. Actually, yeah, there's five. We got Nissa. We've got Liliana. We've got Gideon. We have Ob, and we have Soren. Also, I mean, when you're talking about super friends, you should throw in some of these, like, kind of legendary, amazing one-of cards, like the Gitrog Monster, Archangel Avacyn, Green Warden, Woodland Bellower, Kalidus, like, all these, like, singleton one-of superstars. And, like, the people who carry their luggage are, like, Eili, Eternal Pilgrim, and Sylvan Advocate. So you play this deck with two Nissa's Pilgrimage, huh? You really need more forests? It seems like just fetching forests. It seems like you could do better than that. Than just, you know, adding two more forests to the board, because you are a three-color deck and you only have so many forests in the deck. You don't want to strip all the forests out. If you do, your Nissa won't find anything. But yeah, if it works for you, if you're, you know, if you're tearing it up, by all means, you don't have to worry about me. I am doing all well tonight. How are you, Twisted G-Money? I like this avatar. I mean, I'll never be this guy, but I love his, like, commando belt of potions, right? His commando belt of, what are those? Water balloons? He's just ready. You know, he came to play. We don't have white. And we don't have, like, any kind of control. Let's try to do better. This is better. I guess it depends. I like having a variety of lands on the battlefield. I don't like the basic lands in my three color deck are some of the worst cards in my deck. I really want as many I want duels and I want variety of basics, and having three forests in a three color deck that seems like a wasted opportunity to me. That's all I was getting at. If it works for you, like I said, you don't have to worry about me. Do you run this guy? Do you run Cultivator? If you don't run Cultivator, I'd have to strongly advise you to run Cultivator instead of the Pilgrimage. I mean, the card's awesome. And we don't want our opponent getting a bunch of Evil Leap value, do we? Get that off of my board. This turn he's 2 damage, next turn he's 2 mana. Or 1 mana, but, you know, still great. Slab Hammer, weird. We've got a Slab Hammer, Evo Leap, Fat Stack. Whatever he wanted to do, he couldn't take the Slab Hammer out. Just too important to his strategy. White, green. Man, it's too bad. I can't fetch a forest and cast Eili, but I think I have to go get the forest. You play MTD just on here. I guess that's a question. I've played Magic for about 20 years, well before there was a Duels. I played Magic online when it was beta and free, and I stopped playing it once it cost a lot of money. I started playing Duels a few years ago, and now I just really like playing Duels because I can do it from the comfort of home and I don't have to travel to go to tournaments or to go to Friday Night Magic. So yeah, now I mostly play on here, but I still have paper cards. I keep up my sets. Okay, so here comes his explosive veggies. And he tapped out, so here comes Archangel Avacyn. Now, you say that you're not under pressure, and you can outvalue your opponent anyway. The thing is, maybe your opponents, but when you play me, I plan to put you under pressure. Because that's kind of where this format is right now. I mean, look at how much pressure I can put up every single turn. Look at what I've done to this guy, and I'm not even trying that hard. This hasn't been exactly a smooth draw, and he's still, like, feeling it. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's 10. That's 6. 11. I can put him to 1? Darn it. I can put him to 1. What else can I do? Aili Eternal Pilgrim can come down, and I can flip Avacyn, so I can deal him 8. And put him to 1. I guess the safe route is just Gideon make a dude. Since I can't kill him, I guess that's what I'll do. Okay, I mean, man, this deck is mythic, baby. Look at all this, rare mythic action going on. Love it. So what can my opponent do? He could try to wrath the board, and then Gideon will just kill him. Okay, so he concedes. Let's leave the game and take our reward, because there's no way he's coming back there. I could go through the motions, but I don't think that's necessary. My goal is more games. I don't even know what he was playing. I can't even, like, put that down. It was some kind of ramp deck, and I just steamrolled him, and it wasn't even a fast hand. So the next deck that I have that I'll show you after this game is a Delirium-ish green-black deck. Dredge. Some kind of a dredge pile. One I've become pretty infatuated with. It started out as an awkward relationship, and I didn't think I'd like it at all. And like last night, at 5 a.m., the last deck I played was Delirium, and I was getting my butt handed to me, and it was horrible. And I was pretty frustrated, but I have come around. I've come around on Delirium, and I have found the mix I'm looking for. So I've really enjoyed the deck so far. Are we locked up? We are locked up. So I'll build that deck after another game or two here. Mm-hmm. The decks I'm running, what Delirium cards are you playing on it? I'm playing with a card I absolutely despised when I saw it and picked on people for liking, and that's Kindly Stranger. I'm also playing with Mindrak Demon. Those are the Delirium cards. Then there's Ever After to Reanimate. Deathcap Cultivator also has a Delirium ability. So, it's not a deep Delirium, but I think it's the right ones. Have I posted any of these online? There should be a link right under what you're watching. At MagicDuelsHelper.com is where a lot of my deck lists are posted. We can keep this. I'm a casual player trying to build around Nahiri the Harbinger. Do you have any suggestions? Are you trying to build in duels? Because you only get one of them. And I would strongly suggest not trying to build a deck around a card that you only have one of available to in your 60. But if you're really set on building around Nahiri, I would build, I would just build a Planeswalker deck, probably in Naya, in red and white and green, I think would be best. Because you can use Oath of Nissa to try to draw her more frequently, and you can use Call the Gatewatch to fetch her. You can play a color deck, or is it... Can you play a color deck, or is it just three color deck? I can play whatever colors I want to build up. You build your own decks in duels. Kindly Stranger, not that bad, right? Oh my god, I really thought that Kindly Stranger was the worst. Like, the dirt worst. Horrible. But I played with it, and I played with it in my Delirium deck, and I built a deck around Gather the Pack, and around Vessel of... Nascency. So it always digs up a Fleshbag Marauder or a Kindly Stranger, so it's like they're always finding removal. Ah, that sounds sweet. So there's the guy at MagicDuelsHelper.com, which I strongly recommend you go check out. MagicDuelsHelper.com. Most of my deck lists are posted over there, although they're not going to match what I'm doing over here exactly, because I'm always testing new things. But when I feel good about a build, I usually update it the next day. I'll go in there in the morning and fix it up. So I don't think I can get punished, so let's fire up. This hand is all the control cards in our deck and none of the creatures. There you go. But that's okay. I mean, we're not going to lose this way. We'll only win slower. It's fine to win slower. It's the only thing that matters is that you get the win. Our opponent is mana screwed, so don't run 70 cards in your deck. I can't post it because I'm on Xbox, my friend. But maybe Dr. Claw there can... post a link over to Magic Duels Helper for ya, as that's his site. He takes great care of it. Or you can just search MagicDuelsHelper.com. My decks are all over the all decks section. It has my name next to it, Covert Go Blue. And if you guys haven't followed me yet, and you like what's going on right now, all that I do is play duels, and so I'll play more duels. And I play just about every day, and I've got a lot more decks that I haven't played yet that I want to show you guys. So if you haven't followed me yet, you should follow me, because you have like nothing to lose, and just like more sweet decks to check out, and you know, nothing to lose, everything to gain. So we can hit him with the Quagmire. I want to use a white and a black up. Okay. Oops. Screwed up. I thought I was tapping this because it never highlights. Just more trouble with the game. Hey. Thank you, Dr. Claw. There's a Reavesoul. Yep. it makes me really glad I didn't play Nissa and saved it for a flip, because now we get to flip her, and she'll be out of that Reef Soul range. Do I want to flip up Nissa, or do I want to start drawing with Ob? I guess I do want to do Nissa, because I can still get in with my Shambling Vent. Or no. Well, yeah, I guess Shambling Vent, but I would have rather gotten in with the Quagmire, but the Quagmire tapped. Gotta be a little careful how I tap here in the middle of the night. let's see what we draw with Nissa before we go firing up Vents. If we hit a land, an untapped land, we can Ob right now. And I don't want to go ahead and make a 4-4 because it kind of plays into he might have removal of various types over there, and if he hits his land drops and starts killing my stuff, it's a different game. But if I just start planeswalkering him, there's nothing he can do. You know, the planeswalkers will just take him down over time. Yeah, looking good. Pilgrim's Eye, so here he comes. He's way behind the eight ball, but I'm sure he'll see what he can do here. Okay, so we drew this. If we get a flesh bag, we'll be able to flip Lily. That would also be amazing. So let's look for that. Still looking for that F bag. As we continue to go absolutely nuts on our opponent. Almost whiffed. And I think we can play this and still fire up Hissing Quagmire. And it didn't tap itself this time. Glory, glory, hallelujah. It has Death Touch, so if he blocks it, whatever he blocks with will die. As he just found out. So he can hit my Oath of Nissa, but it's not like that's gonna make me sad or anything. It did its job. It just sits there the rest of the time. I've got the mana to cast my walkers. So he's gonna keep Nissa down. Okay. He's still got 17 life. We're way ahead, but we do have a job to do of actually killing him. And if we draw a whole bunch of cards, that should be a pretty easy job, given time. Okay, so double Advocate. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we can go Advocate, and still attack with Shambling Vent. Alright, bring it. Oath of Willness has been underwhelming for you. I mean, have you missed with it? Have you just bricked and drawn nothing with it? Because if you've drawn anything off it, I mean, I don't think underwhelming is a proper description. I still haven't bricked with it yet. There is a little bit of deck building to it where you have to make sure you have the right mix of land, you have the right mix of creatures and planeswalkers. If you have a deck that's like mostly enchantments, Oath of Nissa will miss. Enchantments, instants, and sorceries, right? So there is some deck building to it, but for the most part, it kind of speaks for itself. I mean, the card's nuts. You play it on turn one and you get this awesome card selection. I don't know what could be wrong. What could be wrong with that? I have an emblem for you. Ha 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 ha. There's my flesh bag. Let's flip out Liliana. Discard you. Swing. How long do you think it will be until they fix priority? I have no idea. I really don't know. I can't. I don't even like try to guess, to be honest. I wish I had a good answer for you there. I think it, man, it's a bad one. It really is. They really shouldn't have. They just shouldn't have allowed that to happen. It's very negative. And I try to keep it positive over here, as you guys, you know, may have become accustomed to. I try to keep the power of positivity. So, I was watching Legend's video today, and at some point he said, we have four Planeswalkers, so we're doing pretty good, and I was like, that is such an understatement. And I would say right now we are doing pretty good. So if I draw a card, I win. I guess I don't have anything that just reads draw a card, though. Let's just kill his stuff. That way he doesn't have to worry about blocking or anything. He could activate his clue. He could die to his clue. Because of the Ob emblem. So, can't really count that game. He was mana screwed pretty much the whole game. So you ready to see that delirium action? Guess what? I'm maxed out my gold again. Dun dun dun. I guess I deleted that deck. I was so disappointed with it last night, but I've come around. Frickin' stranger. Whatever that kindly stranger is. I think that card is so stupid, and yet it did not suck. You know, I understand people who are really frustrated by the glitch, and not everybody is gonna handle things the way I try to handle things, but I can't control how fast programmers at a company like Stainless are gonna fix something like that. That's way out of my control. And no amount of me getting upset is going to help me fix it. So I spent a lot of time this morning after reading about all the people who were very upset about it. And rightfully so. I mean, when you like your game, you hate to see it messed with. But after reading what they said, I kind of grabbed my notebook and I tried to just brainstorm and figure out ways of playing with the priority problem. And I think I've done that, you know. I figured out ways to play with Abbot of Carol Keep, where the odds of the bug screwing me over aren't very high. I removed a lot of the cards that are perpetually bugged from my deck, or I just accepted that they're going to have some bugs to them. And I'm trying not to play decks that get really messed up by priority or specific mana tapping with, like, Awaken cards that, you know, really require your mana to work properly, or scry options. And I've had a pretty good day. The priority hasn't messed with me very much. Trust me, I totally understand that you're frustrated. It's just, I can't, it's not something I can control. So I try not to get upset, and I try to instead figure out ways to work with it, as opposed to always spend my time being upset and railing against it, because I don't think that makes me very fun to be around. And I certainly don't want to have one of those streams where we're just complaining about the game that's so cool all the time. And yeah, I get unlucky. I've had a pretty unlucky day. I've taken a beating most of the day, but that's just part of the game. I try not to get too down about it. I do get salty sometimes, but I think there's a difference between that and complaining about the game that you're trying to enjoy. I think it has bad long-term karma, and it's how people end up walking away from something awesome. Like, I mean, there are a lot of duels content creators, you know, with YouTube channels who I watched for years, and they don't make content anymore. At some point, they threw up their hands, or life got to them, and they're just done. And that, you know, they have thousands of subscribers. I have a very low number of followers and subscribers compared to some of the audiences that these people built. People who, you know, really turn to them for entertainment, which to me is always amazing that you guys would do that. And I don't want to ever kind of take that for granted. And if I let myself only sit around complaining about the game, I know eventually I'll probably also become disenchanted and turn my back on the game. So I try to get away from it. I really do. I know it's hard. And I can't always. I do try to find ways to work with it instead of rail against it. We'll call this a dredge. Programming is a pain in the ass, for the record. Yeah, I believe it. I don't know very much about programming. It's really not my forte. So, I try to have patience and respect for the people that that do it. Could I play my werewolf deck sometime? Yeah, I played it really early in the day yesterday, which is probably why you missed it. Maybe I'll pull it out. The other part to all of that, like, I know I'm frustrated, I'm sure you're frustrated when cards don't work the way they should, especially if you've, you know, played previous versions of Duels or Paper Magic. But, you know, you kind of have to play the game you have, not the game you should have. This is what they released, and we're gonna do our best with it, and hopefully they get around to fixing it sooner, not later. I'll try to bust out the werewolf deck for you next, okay? Is that cool? What should I call you? There's so many numbers and letters in your name, I don't know what to call you. Now I'll call you D4, I guess. Wow, this is a very flamboyant dude that we found in this lightning bolt fitted swamp. Crazy elf we got here. Days? Oh, Days of the Dead. Oh, I get it now. Isn't it funny how, like, you can look at something, like, 100 times and not see it? And now I see it. Now I see it. So we can keep this. I think I'll try to wait on the Gather the Pack and go with the Vessel instead. Because if I do that, maybe I can get two creatures off my Gather. But if I do that, I don't cast Gather next turn. No, I think we'll lead on Gather. We got a pretty anemic draw otherwise. So we can go gather into vessel into hopefully another black source. And then we can grasp and then ob. Yep, sounds good. And we'll have delirium. So then we'll probably get our kindly stranger on. So here comes a Sylvan Ranger. Everybody's favorite little buddy. So it looks like we're going to face one of those like 4 or 5 color planeswalker decks. Pretty tough matchup, probably. I don't know, you know, who's favored against it. I think you have to put up a really quick clock, like some kind of a tempo deck. Well, I don't know what my opponent has. I know I already have a Kindly Stranger. I kind of want this Reclamation Sage, because I really don't know what will happen in this game. I want to be prepared if he does something like a From Beyond or an Evo Leap. It is my only Reclamation Sage in the deck, so if I bin it, I have to draw another Ever After or Green Warden to get it back. Or Liliana. You got me. He hit me. He hit me right in the arm. So, do I want a vessel or do I want to play the stranger and see if he has a way to kill it? I have 3 types in my yard. So it's not going to, like, go off or anything yet. So, I think we'll do the vessel. And we'll do it on his end step so we have a better idea of what we should be keeping. Because right now, he's not doing much. But he's got his 4 colors on. Does he have a Planeswalker? He has a Woodland Wanderer. That's pretty good. Especially when he's got that stupid little 1/1 to eat our flesh bag. So let's try to find something to deal with that. 4 types. Oh, what just happened? So our choices are these. I will take you. Quagmire can come down. Fleshbag can come down. We're gonna take a bump. Gonna take a bump. Not much I can do about it. If I play Kindly Stranger and he kills it, but if I play it and he doesn't kill it, I can have the option of flipping it next turn instead of using Ob. And either way, next turn I can grasp and flesh bag, so let's do that. We may have a problem with that Lumbering Falls, but he doesn't seem to have the mana yet to fire it up. He'll need another blue. He'll probably go get that right now. Call in the Gatewatch. Call in the Gatewatch. Giddy. Yep, Gideon's good. Does he have double white? I think he just fetched it. Okay, we want to activate this on our turn, because if your opponent can kill Kindly Stranger in response to the flip, then it never transforms, and if it never transforms, the ability doesn't resolve. So we definitely want to use the ability, like, this turn. So what else can we do with this turn? We can Vessel. No, we can't. Well, we can put it out there, and we can leave up Grasp of Darkness. That may be a good idea. Here I am using frickin' Kindly Stranger. Feels like such a stupid card to me, but here we are. Making it work. Vessel or grasp? We can bet that Gideon will come down. When Gideon comes down, I guess we do have to be ready to clear away some creatures and try to force him to protect her. So, let's see what happens. Maybe it's Chandra, since he fetched Gideon but doesn't have the mana to cast it. It's Nissa's renewal. Okay. Yippee. We don't have ways to kill small creatures, so I guess we just have to grasp one of these. Might as well. Otherwise our flesh bag's never going to do much. And if they just sit out there, maybe they'll turn on his Westvale Abbey eventually. Deck box is up. I'll have to check that out. I can't wait to. You are the man, Doctor. You are the Doctor. Let's get Ob onto the battlefield. And let's get the vessel onto the battlefield. First, we'll tick up, get some cards moving, and put that down. Pretty much every gather the pack and every vessel seems like it hits either a kindly stranger or a fleshbag marauder, and then eventually Ever After, like, gets going. Pretty cool stuff. There's Chandra. So, plus Chandra, attack my Ob. Yep. Take out my Ob. Or, you can get me really low. Let's see what he decides to do. I'll fix it tomorrow, I'm sure. I'm sure I will fix it. So we have to deal 5. We can do that. If we do this, and then fire up... Yeah, we can take Chandra down. Disperse on his Chandra? No, on Kindly Stranger. I would disperse on Chandra. But I guess now I'm fired up, so I gotta go in. So we might be in a bind here against the Planeswalker deck. This deck doesn't really put up that same kind of pressure, and we also never found our top end, you know? We never made Ever After happen. It's looking bad. I don't have any huge effect like Chandra in this deck. I mean, Chandra's just legendary. Disperse is a really good card in Planeswalker decks. Needed an untapped land, did not get one. So he can go Gideon, 2-2, Lumbering Falls. Yeah, he's got it. No problem. So that was my green-black Delirium. And that is probably a really bad matchup for it against walkers. It certainly doesn't put up enough pressure to really make that a competitive game. It is really strong against any other kind of aggressive creature deck, but not against the Walker deck. It is really strong against anything that's trying to, like, curve out humans, Eldrazi, all of that kind of stuff. Werewolves, it's good against those. It is not good. It is not good in this game that you just saw with Planeswalkers. Wrong answer. That's better. Opponent mulliganing. Okay, Quags. Do we want to play that first? I guess we can curve out this way. So I guess we'll just take the risk that we can play the Quagmire without messing up curve later. Got invited to Two-Headed Giant, which is very much not my thing. It's okay if it's your thing, it's just totally not my thing. Wow, my opponent is mana screwed. That's a shame. I will start playing faster because I always feel bad for taking too long when my opponent has no lands. I guess for now we'll just curve out and let the vessel hang around. We don't need delirium just yet. We'll just pound this tent pole into the ground and call it a day. Well, they hit the second land drop. Is it good enough to do something? Alchemist Vial. Well, maybe they'll start drawing land. But I don't know. Missing those land drops, you just don't want to be there. You just don't ever want to be there. Not the way you want to be. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could have played more things this turn, or played this turn out a little stranger. But, ha, stranger. See what I did there? Could have played this turn stranger. Alright. There's the Ever After. See if we can get delirium off this flip. Huh, all creatures, never mind. What's the best one? Oh, we drew Ever After, didn't we? We drew Ever After, so we just want to keep the big creatures in there. Yeah, I'll take you, Pikachu. Give the guy gold before you win? That would be a real karma thing. That's a really nice idea. I'd never even thought of it, but yeah, maybe I will. Four, five, Ever After, get those. Alchemist Vial, yep. And Green Warding can get me back, I think Vessel, just draw more cards. Bellower will... Ever After is on the bottom, but now we're going to shuffle, so we'll get that out of the deck. Get that guy. Get that back. Cast this. Again. Tell you what, we'll give him the gold if he toughs it out. If he takes his next turn and then passes the turn back to me and he's still here, I will concede and give him the gold. I will concede before I attack on my next turn if he is still here. Nope, he did not. He left. I would have probably left there too, so not being judgy. Just, you know what? When I meet somebody of firm character who can, who takes their beating, I'll show them the respect. All right, let's get the wolves in here for, I forgot who asked. I know I've seen them in here multiple times, and they wanted to see me play Wolves, so let's do it. I've got a few adjustments to make that I've been testing, and I think they're good. I think I pulled out... There's a few cards I know I took out. I think that this might have been one of them. Eh, let's just wait till I get my iPad opened up here. Wolves Tier 1 confirmed? How's that? Did you confirm it? Are you confirming Tier 1 Wolf status? Just a feeling, or have you played 100 games and won 99 of them against top decks? I know, a Hydra is not a wolf, but it's such a good finisher. It's like just when your opponent stabilizes, you play Hydra and you fetch a Rogue's Passage, and if the opponent can't kill the Hydra, they just lose. Which deck type is Tier 1? Tier 1 is what people say when they mean it's among the very, very best decks that you can play in a metagame. And a metagame is made up of the decks that are the strongest available. That makes sense? I think so. That's like the quick nutshell. So, Firecraft, Rider, Geist Bandit, no Judgment. Judgment-free zone. Oh yeah, that's right. So this is very flavorful, but I really do think it's a good enough card to play with, and that is Rabid Bite. So we're gonna put in Rabid Bite here. The art is a man biting a werewolf. It's kind of weird, but this is actually a pretty good card so far for me. In that it can deal damage to target creature equal to another creature's power. So that's not a fight mechanic. Like, if I use the Pack Guardian, it deals 4 damage to their creature, but their creature doesn't damage the Pack Guardian. So as long as I have a creature, it's a good card. Also, the Oath of Chandra. I'm finding that making sure you can kill things that have 3 toughness is getting very important in this game. Like, a lot, even more so than I expected it to be. And I was, very early on, I said that this game is not going to be about 2 toughness, it's going to be about 3 toughness. So this is where I'm at with my wolves. Yeah, this is where my wolf power is at. It's a little more mid-range, but, I mean, it can get some amazing draws. What's really important is that you have a great 2-drop. A Recruiter or a Pacifist are both great on turn 2. This is no slouch either. And then you get to follow that with a solid turn 3 or 4. Alright. I think we can take that for a spin. We have so many... Our deck has so many creatures and lands that Oath of Nissa usually has no problem getting an awesome threat for just 1 mana. It would be great to have 3 damage at instant speed, but Fiery Impulse isn't reliable that way, and I don't want to discard to Lava Axe. So I think I'm kind of... I think Chandra's kind of where I need to stay. I would like 2 mana, 3 damage, instant speed very much. I promise you, I would. But not something that I have access to. And it's more important that I kill the thing I want to kill than worry about my werewolf transforming. More important that that thing that must die, die. Getting sleepy. 3 in the morning. We'll see how much later this particular party's gonna run. What haven't I played? I didn't play my green-white aggro deck, which is a deck I like quite a bit. 9 in the morning over there. Good morning. I guess I'm with your morning coffee or tea. Thank you for spending your morning with me. Guys, if you haven't followed me yet, it really is a low-risk proposition, because I'm just going to make more duels, and I'm going to keep tuning decks, and I'm going to share decks. I stream about every day, and I've got a lot more decks to build and a lot more decks to show you. So if you like duels, that's all I do. If you like what I'm putting down, please hit the follow button. Come back and see me again. Because it's always more fun with an audience. Mm-hmm. So, Pacifist. Pacifist is 3/3. And if it can't attack unless you control a creature with power 4 or greater, but it flips into a 4/4. So then it can attack. Still, it's a real brick wall, and it looks like our opponent's going to play... Well, I guess it's not a brick wall for a menace creature. Maybe our opponent's playing red aggro. The new red aggro type deck. Make a spirits deck. I have not made a spirits deck yet. You've never seen me stream at this time, yeah, because it's way too late here. It's 3 in the morning, but I just can't sleep. I can't sleep when there's so many good new cards to play with. So I don't think I can take the time to flip my pacifist next turn. I think I have to keep up on the board and I have to make sure I hit land drops. So that's kind of the situation we're in. Well, I drew a land, so maybe I can. Interesting situation. I think we'll just play the Abbot this turn. It looks like we're gonna have to be the control because he's the aggro and he's on the play, so makes sense. Would have been nice to get that, but oh well. We're just trying to hit a land, really. Are there any good spirits? Yeah, there just aren't a ton of great spirits. We have kind of a spirit flash deck because we play Rattle Chains along with a wolf. What is it? We play Rattle Chains and we play the Spirit Wolf that has flash, so it's as close as I come right now. Yep. Opponent has all the good cards, but don't worry, we've got time. We'll get there. Okay. So we can shoot his wolf and Oath Anissa. We can also play a Breakneck Rider, and then we have a pair of 3/3s that he'll have to get around. But he has another pump spell. That probably won't be too hard for him. So I think we're gonna go ahead and shoot his wolf. And we're gonna try to Oath for probably another land. Titan Strength won't save it. See what we oath up. All land. Awesome. Go figure. It's okay that we're not like running them over. They're the aggro. We are gonna be the bigger deck with bigger creatures in the long run, so we just have to play like it. Dragon Fodder is a card I liked a lot more in the last set. Well, now he can kill that. Okay, so he's down to 2 cards. And he's getting his beats down. Fiery Impulse, man, that is the card of the night. I've been Fiery Impulse so many times today. Card of the day, I suppose I should say. Let's get these guys out there. Big old 4/4. See what he wants to do. I have to read that card again. I forget what it even does. It's like, I know it's a 2/1, and whenever. Pause. Whenever it blocks or becomes blocked by a creature, it deals 1 damage to that creature. If no spells were cast, transform it into a 3/2. Whenever it blocks or becomes blocked, 2 damage. Yeah. Yeah. I guess that's fine. If he has a Titan Strength, so be it. Oh, of course, he has Fiery Impulse number 3. I told you, it's Fiery Impulse night, dude. This is like the 5th time today I've been Fiery Impulse 3 or more times in one game. So, let's get those down. Let's see how much longer he can draw Fiery Impulses. Ah, not attacking. Love it. About time. And that's gonna flip, and let's dig before we flip. Cool. Let's get the Pack Guardian. Alright, there's the Rabid Bite. So, it's risky to use this right here because our opponent could have another removal spell, but he's already used all his Fiery Impulses, three of them, and he didn't attack last turn, which tells me he doesn't have a removal spell, so I want to fire this off. And what I really want to do is I want to keep my... I want to keep this guy, because if I flip it back, I can dig up more creatures. So, I'll take the risk with this creature. Gotcha. I want to attack. I'm at 12. He's got 1/1s. He's got two cards in hand, and he couldn't attack last turn. I'm going to wait a turn, because I can. Doesn't hurt to wait. I'm the control. Being conservative is probably in my best interest, even when it's probably very getting safe to do it, to get in there. So let's see. Yep, he's playing out. He's tapped out. He's going to flip my wolves with that play. But that does mean I get the other side, which means I can dig up more wolves. And I can just pass if I want to flip, because I have a flash creature. Sweet. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. I can just flip them right back and play Pack Guardian. So, I think that's the play. Yeah. Can't use the ability. If I use the ability, I won't be able to play the Pack Guardian. Oh, does he remember? I think he forgot. I think he forgot about this card. Thoughts on flip artifact? Junk. That's my first impression. Hate to say it, I'd like to like the card, but it's not for me. It's really not my type of card. Yep, he's got Titan Strength. But wherever he puts it, eh. I kind of blocked in a way that doesn't... It's not a good Titan Strength. It's just a 2-for-1. So he is going to trade with my Duskwatch, because that's where I draw more wolves. And he's going to play a second Flamekin. Going to flip the wolf back. Almost time to turn the corner now, though. Yep, time to turn the corner. Let's see what our little red deck friend has. He is out of here. Let's finish this game off. So we outwolfed our little red aggro. We didn't even draw any of our really big cards. He seems to like that. Like, I haven't seen anybody else playing this card. It's an interesting card. We did have to kill it. We had to get it off the board to win, but eh. Still not overly impressed by it or anything. So, 11. You can trade. If I pass the turn and he doesn't have an attack, I can flip. But I can't kill him. I don't really want to trade with that guy. So I think, let's offer him a wolf. It's a real awkward block here, right? Because I don't want to trade any of these creatures for it. I really don't. But I guess we're so far ahead that we should. He has to block or it's lethal. So he'll trade it up to the Pack Guardian, and then we'll have three creatures to his one. Down to three. If he doesn't play anything, I get to flip. Okay, he's gonna fodder. I think Dragon Fodder got a lot worse without Foundry Street Denizen. I think that's really clear, at least to me. So he can block everything this turn. Yep, and he has to. And the Hydra to be the big finisher, because we can go fetch the one of Rogue's Passage. Yep, I think in the new meta you really want to play like Ember Haulers, and you want to play creatures with two toughness at least on turn two. That's the thing for me. And he doesn't play anything. I get to flip. Ooh, I get to cast this face up, right? Ooh, so I'm working on my triggers. So that thing triggers, it'll flip this over, but before it flips, I can activate it? Sweet. Oh boy. Yes, I will flip it. Love it. Okay.